evening. I'm pleased to welcome parents, family, friends, school board members, Superintendent Stelzer, and honorable members of the Celina Senior High School teaching and guidance staff to the commencement exercises for the class of 1992. The invocation for our commencement ceremony this evening will be delivered by the Reverend Douglas Meyer, pastor of St. John's Lutheran Church. Please stand.
Would you pray with me, please? This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Gracious God, we thank you for days of special celebration in life, and especially for this day and this hour. And with grateful hearts, we praise you for our graduates, our sons and our daughters, and for bringing them to this beautiful conclusion, and yet at the same time, new beginning in their life. With your presence now, bring your joy and your peace to this celebration. In the name of Christ the Lord, amen. You may be seated. That you will always be hope-filled people as you live your lives. We live in a magnificent world. Yes, there are problems, and there are some big problems. But I like to see problems as challenges. And challenges are best met by hope-filled people. As you go forth from this day, may you give your very best, and may you do your very best in leaving this world an even better place. Congratulations, God bless you, and we need every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Pastor Meyer. This time I'd like to introduce the senior class president, Mr. Jason Brackley.
That's tough to follow. Good evening and welcome to the commencement ceremonies for class of 1992. It's going to be short, it's going to be brief. I broke my tongue this afternoon when I was eating and it hurts to talk, so it's going to be short. First of all, I'd like to thank all the parents in this building today, because if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here. And, you know, you mean a lot, and the students love you, and it means a lot. Next, I'd like to thank all the faculty of Celina Senior High School. It's their effort and all their work that got us here today. Now, I'm not saying we're all going to graduate because our grades aren't turned in yet, but I think we all know that when the teachers walk in that building, that they always put their hardest. And I really think that, you know, sometimes students don't appreciate it, but I think, you know, when after we're gone and we look back at this, we're going to realize just, you know, how good they really were to us. And, you know, sometimes we don't always respect them. But I think, you know, it takes a lot to be a teacher. And, you know, that's basically... Finally, what else can you say? Hey, they're teachers. It takes a lot of guts. Finally, like I said, it's going to be short. I'd like to thank my class for great years of high school. Lots of memories. Memories that I'll carry with me for the rest of my life, and you'll carry with you for the rest of yours. They were great. And, you know, basically all I have to say is, last thing, party on. And stay out of trouble, okay?
Sitting before us this evening is a group of seniors who throughout the past 4 years have achieved some amazing accomplishments. And at this time in our program, I'd like to highlight some of those accomplishments for you. As I call off each of the seniors' names, would you please stand and remain standing until the end of this portion, please. Andrew Amaron, National Merit Scholarship finalist. She will attend Northwestern University. Emily Archer, Knights of Columbus Scholarship. She will attend The Ohio State University. Douglas Billerman, Athletic Scholarship to attend Huntington College. Jennifer Braun, Music Performance Grant and Honors Grant to attend Huntington College. Tricia Brookhart, Scarlet and Gray Scholarship from The Ohio State University. Caroline Christopher, Class Valedictorian, National Merit Scholarship finalist. the Robert C. Byrd Congressional Scholarship. Caroline will attend Northwestern University. Tim Fast, Merit Scholarship to attend the University of Toledo. Tim was also one of our three National Merit Scholarship finalists. Amy Gillis, Academic Scholarship to attend Wright State University, Lake Campus. James Gottner, Scholarship sponsored by the Moose Lodge. James will attend General Motors Institute. Tim Haley, Athletic Scholarship to attend the University of Finland. Cynthia Heyman, Scholarship from the MED Foundation of Community Hospital. Cindy will attend Ohio University. Christine Hare, Class Salutatorian, Dorothy Lammer Scholarship Award, Mercer County Ohio State University Alumni Scholarship, Ohio State University Class of 1967 Alumni Scholarship, University Scholarship to attend the Ohio State University. Tracy Hiley. Tracy has received the Future Business Leader Scholarship. She will attend Ohio University. Keith Hyland, Athletic Scholarship to attend Tri-State University. Christopher Kincaid, Freshman Honor Scholarship to attend Mount Vernon Nazarene College. Kristen Klosterman, Freshman Honor Scholarship to attend Mount Vernon Nazarene College. Kristen Klosterman, she'll receive the Mary Rowe Moore Award to attend the University of Cincinnati. Rachel Lay, Class Salutatorian, Academic Scholarship to attend Ohio Northern University. Carrie Meyer, Synod Endowed Scholarship, Lutheran Brotherhood Scholarship, Buckeye Girls State Scholarship. Carrie will attend Wittenberg University. Nikki Moeller, Mercer Savings Bank Art Scholarship and an Art Scholarship to attend St. Francis College. Nikki, by the way, did design our cover for our program this evening. Rob Hollenkamp, Western Ohio Education Foundation Scholarship to attend the Wright State University Lake Campus. Missy Mulholland, AAA Scholarship, Spencerville American Legion Scholarship, University Trustee Scholarship to attend Ohio Wesleyan University. Carrie Poore, Athletic Scholarship to attend the University of Notre Dame. Libby Proach, Scholarship sponsored by the Moose Lodge. Libby will attend Ohio State University. Jason Reichert, Hazardous Waste Scholarship to attend the University of Finland. Mona Lisa Rogers, Nursing Scholarship to attend Purdue University. Sarah Seal Scott, Athletic Scholarship to attend Ashland University. Aaron Schreckler, Athletic Scholarship to attend Ohio University. Ellen Smith, Scarlet and Gray Scholarship to attend The Ohio State University. Amanda Sutter, Manasaw Cutler Scholarship to attend Ohio University. Shannon Teagarden, Merit Scholarship to attend Tiffin University. Tasha Tolan, the Lawrence Evans Memorial Scholarship and Talent Scholarship to attend Huntington College. Amy Umstead, Class Salutatorian, Grace College Fund Scholarship and Trustee Scholarship to attend Bethel College. And Marty Whited, an Academic Grant to attend Middlebury College. Please join me in a round of applause for these students and their. Thank you, students. You may be seated. One special member of the class of 1992 of Celina Senior High School is one of our two foreign exchange students. Milton Cruz, will you please stand? Milton came to us last summer from Brazil. He has shared many experiences. I know he was an active participant in the dances, both of the homecomings, and at first when he arrived, kind of walked around the hallways of the school with awe, and he has fit in real well. The students, I know, have benefited also from the cultural exchange that we've had. Milton, you have added very substantially to this class, and we have a lot of fond memories, and we wish you the very best. Thank you. Milton Fisk. Present the Senior Class Advisor Award. Mr. Self.
Every year we try to recognize a person that has, in one way or another, gone above and beyond, I guess, a call of duty to receive their diploma and to complete the requirements at Celina Senior High School. And a group of students and myself, we try to select someone who has overcome some difficulty and sometimes a physical difficulty to stay with it and to graduate in spite of all obstacles. And this year, the Senior Class Advisor Award goes to Ryan Hummer. On down to the
climb around.
This time, we'd like to make several scholarship presentations to members of the graduating class. The students, or graduates, I should say, are unaware of the selections. Sitting behind me to my left are several members of our community representing various agencies, organizations, and industry, each of whom has donated money anywhere in the amounts ranging from $200 up to $1,500. I think this evening you'll be very impressed at some of the recipients and the amounts of money that they will be receiving for aid for their further education. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Tom May, who's representing the Grand Lake Fraternal Order of Eagles. Mr. May.
Hi, I'm Tom May, chairman of the Celina Eagles Lodge 1291 Scholarship Committee, and this is Jerry Gerben and Willis Gilligan, who are on the committee. Once again, it gives me great pleasure to be able to announce that the committee has decided to increase the contributions thanks to the generous donations received from the community and surrounding area. This year, it is my honor to award two worthy students with scholarships valued at $1,291 each. Before I present the award, I would like to thank all the members of the Celina Eagles Lodge 1291 for their support, and to the members of the Scholarship Committee for their time and commitment. This year, two awards will be presented to one young lady and gentleman. The gentleman carries a 2.98 grade point average and is ranked 70th in his class. This student has elected to pursue a degree at Tri-State University, where he will major in engineering, drafting, and design technology. Would Keith Heilman please step up here, please? Keith, on behalf of the Celina Eagles Scholarship Committee, we would like to present you with this award worth $1,291. Congratulations. The young lady carries a 3.21 grade point average and is ranked 49th in her class. This student has elected to pursue a degree in pharmacy at Toledo University. Would Heather Beckman please step up here? Heather, on behalf of the Celina Eagles Scholarship Committee, we would like to present you this award for $1,291. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Representing the Jean Green Vocational Scholarship Committee, this is Sandy Monbeck.
Well, I'm real proud to be chosen to give these awards. Jean was a real good friend of mine. And these scholarships are made possible by an awful lot of people who put in a lot of time. They take payroll deductions all the time to make the scholarships available. And they have their barbecue chicken dinner. We have a lot of fun with that. And when this first started, the first year they did a scholarship, it was one $500 scholarship. This year we're about to present four $1,000 scholarships. So I'd like to say congratulations to these students. And if they'd come forward and get these. First one being Kim Davis, who will attend Wright State University and major in business management. The next one being Rodney Poor, who will attend Lima Technical College in mechanical design. David Wilkins, who will attend DeVry for electronics technician. And the last one going to Tiffany Dwenger, who will attend Lima Technical College for information processing and administration support. Congratulations to all of you, and with everybody's continued support, hopefully another good scholarship effort for next year. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Cindy. Representing the Celina VFW to present the Tommy Turnip Seed Scholarships, Mr. Bill Mason-Brink.
Also to help me present this is our post commander, Don Howard. It's an honor and a privilege to represent our Celina VFW to present these awards. This is our 10th year, and it seems like it gets more difficult each year to choose which person, which student will receive one of our scholarships. About the only thing that makes it easy is I'm like the guy on TV with a commercial selling carpet. I don't care if I make any money, but I sure love giving away these scholarships. This year, we're giving away $500 scholarships. And as I name you, would you please come forward and give an honorable from Don. Linda Marie Black. Christina Hoster. And Tina Stone.
This year, for the first year, we're pleased to present a scholarship in memory of a young graduate who graduated last year. In his untimely death, it was felt by the family, members of the school, that a memorial scholarship in his name would be most appropriate and most fitting. It's my pleasure to introduce to you Ms. Debbie Wilson, who's representing the Jim and Charlotte Wilson family. Debbie?
Good evening. 1 year ago, my family and I were sitting here, as many of you are, with all the excitement and anticipation. We were watching an ending of one chapter and the exciting beginning of a new one. Unfortunately, my our brother, Randy Wilson, didn't get the opportunity to live out that new exciting chapter. But out of this tragedy, an exciting and hopefully profitable opportunity has come out of this. This opportunity has been titled the Randy A. Wilson Memorial Scholarship. While at CSHS, Randy excelled in varsity football for 4 years. Number 83 became familiar to all Bulldog fans. He was a member of Student Council, Winter Homecoming Court, Prom Court, and Hillsdale Baptist Church. Before his untimely death, Randy had planned to achieve his lifelong goal of becoming a state highway patrolman. In September of 1991, after facing the loss of the Wilson family decided to establish a scholarship in memory of Randy. With the generous contributions made by family, friends, and the community, this was made possible. Randy was a very special person to many of us, and we felt that this would be the most effective way of keeping his spirit alive. This scholarship will be presented to an individual who resembles Randy's personality, involvement, and achievements. Randy was known as a loving and caring individual who many admired. The purpose of the scholarship is to financially assist those qualified individuals who wish to further their education at an approved 2 or 4 year college, university, or trade or technical school. The amount of this annual scholarship will be $500. Our family would like to thank all of you who applied. We had many qualifying applicants. Therefore, this year we are happy to announce that 2 individuals have been selected and will divide the scholarship amount, each receiving $250. The 2 recipients of the first annual Randy A. Wilson Memorial Scholarship are Matt Fortcamp and Larry McKeever.
Representing the Celina American Legion Post 210 and Sons of American Legion, Mr. Ron Miller.
First of all, I'd like to congratulate all of you seniors. I have 4 scholarships to give away tonight. 3 of them from the Legion and 1 of them from the Sons of American Legion. First of all, we miss Don Outs.
$1,000 apiece, and they are meant for individuals who are going on to
field or study of education. Hopefully we can have a few more good faculty. Winners this year, Jennifer Braun. Carrie Meyer. Representing Metropolitan Environmental, present this scholarship from his agency, Mr. Alan Smith.
On behalf of the Board of Directors, the officers and employees of Metropolitan Environmental, a company in environmental and industrial waste management, it's our pleasure to present $1,000 per year to a student attending the University of Findlay majoring in hazardous materials management. This year it's our pleasure to present $1,000 per year to Jason Riker.
leadership offices of the Future Business Leaders of America, both local and state offices, member of the Latin Club, Environmental Club, and Young Republicans. She was awarded the Celina Senior Outstanding Communication Award, as well as the Celina Senior Carolyn Bear Award. Congratulations to Tracy Hiley, daughter of Randy and Pam Hiley.
This is the second year for the Paul H. Mormon Scholarship Award. This year, the scholarship is in the amount of $1,000. And this year's recipient is Christine Auburn. Christine?
And let them know that we are deeply indebted and appreciative
of the thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars worth of scholarships that were presented here this evening and annually at commencement exercises. Thank you so much. Let's have a round of applause. Time for our valedictory address. This year, our valedictorian is Caroline Christopher. Caroline has excelled above and beyond even the normal curriculum that is offered, even above the college prep curriculum that is offered at Celina Senior High School. She has earned a 4.03 accumulative grade point average on a 4-point scale, due to weighted grades in many, many advanced placement courses. It's my privilege and honor to introduce to you our class valedictorian, Ms. Caroline B. Christopher. Caroline.
Whether going off to college, joining the armed services, entering the workforce, or starting a family, our personal hopes and ambitions will carry us through. But our responsibilities to ourselves and to each other do not end here tonight. When you look at these rows of caps and gowns in front of you, you're looking at the men and women who may discover a cure for AIDS, break down the barriers of prejudice and racism throughout the world, destroy the nuclear weapons supply, and clean up the environment. The responsibilities which we take on when we take off these caps and gowns probably are much heavier than what they actually seem. Although graduation gives each of us a certain amount of freedom, the knowledge which we have gained together over the years gives us an obligation to the world around us and to each other. That obligation calls us to be active rather than apathetic in becoming the citizens of tomorrow. As we take one last look at ourselves and at each other as high school students, we have to wonder where all of us will be in another 13 years. All of the experiences which we have had together until now have made us who we are today. The journey leading us to tonight's commencement has shaped our identities, just the experiences, the people, and the choices which we will encounter after tonight will shape us further in the future to become everything that we will allow ourselves to be. Whatever our final destination may be, we have discovered that the true joy of life lies in the journey itself and not necessarily the goal. For us, the members of the class of 1992, it was a long, hard road, but never regret, because you'll never know the road not taken. Our ties to one another have remained constant through all of the experiences, and will continue to do so as we all shine on into the future. And to the members of the Celina Senior High School class of 1992, I have one thing left to say. Free at last, free at last, praise God Almighty.
this time, I'm pleased and proud to make a presentation of the senior class of 1992 at Celina Senior High School. Mr. Klostman, and members of the Board of Education of Celina City Schools, I'm proud to present to you these candidates for diplomas, each of whom has satisfactorily completed all coursework, requirements, and policies as prescribed by the General Assembly, along with the state and local boards of education. Mr. Klostman and Mr. Fettes.
Julie Ann Carlson, Board of Distinction. Matthew G. Cromwell. Caroline Gumala Christopher, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Milton R. Cruz. Rebecca J. Sisko. Ryan R. Davenport. Heather Renee Williams. J. E. Dahl. Julie Ann Kobe. Christopher M. Eblin. Carla S. Kohler. John D. Ellis. Jackie K. Creighton, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies.
Stick.
Pete John Ireland. Erica L. Brunden. Brent A. Hole. Gina Matthew Hahn, Award for Distinction for Mission Service. Chad A. Howell. Cynthia Sue Heyman, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Clarence E. Hughes. Jennifer Kathleen Hammond. Ryan Christopher Hunger. Pamela Marie Hartman. Sean E. Houston. Christine Ann Hare, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Christopher Wood Jones, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Stacy Lynn Heck, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Aaron M. Kincaid, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Holly Marie Himmelgar, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies.
Thank you.
Christine Junot. Robert L. Mullenkamp. Karen Ann Canary, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Joshua Munsinger. Kristen Michelle Kindeside. John C. Nagy, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Kristen L. Osterman, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Steve J. Niekamp, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Linda Marie Lapham, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Jerry Michael Nussbaum. Jennifer Diane LaRue, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Ryan J. Payne. Carmen Lee. Sean R. Payne. Jennifer Nicole Leist, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Christian G. Prince. Christina Marie Lindemeyer. Tom L. Pruitt. Terry L. Lockwood. Distinction for Basic Studies. 4 of the Board of Distinction Provision Standard. Jenny Renee Cowell. Douglas M. Stroll. Stacy Renee Printer, Award of Distinction for Racial Studies. David E. Sunderland.
Thank you.
Jill E. Wendell, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Stacy S. Fontanini, sitting in the back row in a wheelchair. Jill Suzanne Westerfield, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Marty A. Whitehead, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies. Jennifer Renee Wilder. Christine Ann Wiley, Award of Distinction for Basic Studies.
Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness,